kickoff right here. We are about to take over with 98 Michael Vick as our quarterback, unless we just break the kick all the way with Tyreek Hill for the ZFarls play of the day nominee. All right. So we have Michael Vick as our quarterback right now. We're going to put him in the Wildcat by using the right stick for the QB package. So that's what we're going to do. We're also going to make sure we sub in. I mean, Gronk is great, but we'll put Donald Penn in just to make sure we've got plenty of beef. We're going to utilize the blast right. We're at the 3-yard line. This is a good red zone formation. Brown's playbook is what we're in right now. They have some good Wildcat. We're going to motion Penn over, snap it. There'll be no Ezekiel Elliott coming across, and Michael Vick flip touchdown. That's his first career touchdown, 98 overall. We've got gameplay up on the channel, guys, with Gunslinger. Make sure to check it out. That is a little early nominee for ZFarls play of the day. It's the debut you've been waiting for, guys. Michael Vick, this is the 98 Gunslinger. We're in the Colts offensive playbook. A lot of people have been asking what's a good playbook. Shovel option scheme, you know I like it. We're going to toss it out. David Johnson break a tackle. User truck right there. So we pick up a little gain there on second down, but we needed a little bit more. I am going to go 5 wide right here and see if we can roll out against Vic. We have DeAndre Hopkins. We have the Jerry Rice. And we're going to go with the play Browns unders right here. We're going to run it from right to left so that Vic is left-handed. He can make his reads, make his throws, get out of the pocket, and hopefully capitalize, run away from some blitzers on this play. So let's see. Looks like we got left side open. I think we might have thrown over the line right there with Vic. So an unfortunate move by Vic right there. Illegal forward pass. We are going to go for it because it's 4th and 12. And we're Honey Badgers. We're trying to make some plays in this one. That was a tough breakdown of the play. Like, we got that. We got what we wanted right there, but it just didn't work out in our favor. So now we need a 12-yard route. We're going to go to Z-spot. We're going to see if this Vic can throw, if he can throw with medium range, if he can throw with accuracy. We know we can run. Felt pretty fast right there. I did pull the right trigger, and I felt like that might have thrown me off my game a little bit. Looks like the heat's going to come in off the right edge, so we are going to try and pick it up. And there's Vic with the throw. We hold for the possession catch, and that worked out for us. So let's get back to the run game a little bit, because this guy is utilizing the FZ3 sky that seems to have not so many rushers on the field. I'm going to call a play like PA divide shot, see if we can get Vic to scramble out of the pocket. I mean, that's my main focus on this drive. I'm going to over-scramble if I can, because I really want to see, you know, what the speed hype is about. We haven't had a possession yet, really, with him. We only had one carry out of Wildcat earlier. You see him bringing down the safeties, so we're going to see what works right here. He did drop a spy in the middle, and we tried to outrun it. We took a hit, but we got 8 yards. So that's a good sign early on our first kind of real scramble up the middle, that even with the spy on a DT, even though we weren't really moving our fastest right there, we were able to still pick up 9 yards. That could be pretty crucial for us. You see the safeties coming up again. And we couldn't take off right there. We wanted to. It makes it 3rd and inches. Let's see if Vic can scramble. And this is just something I'm going to have to get used to. Like, I should have taken that early throw to Johnson. I wanted more. I thought I could almost outrun him. And then I could playmaker him and force and get everybody going up the field. So that was kind of what I was thinking. We're going to go goal line. We're going to go to the PA Power O. We're going to do this. We're going to try and scramble Vic. All right, so a bit of a wind up there because we were rolling away from his good side. That's obviously a big time no-no with Vic, is you don't want to roll to his right. You want to be rolling to his left so you can throw on the run. Even with Gunslinger, he had no time to get that throw off. And so that was on us. Let's see, pressure. We're going to roll left, so we're going to slide left. Wow, and we just flat out didn't pick up the pressure from the left tackle right there. Left tackle was open. Vic is now super tired. 3rd and 19. We've already thrown this moss route one time. He's gonna know it's coming. We got 12 seconds before the 2 minute warning. The slot man in motion right. We're gonna throw it. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, Fitz. So L Fitz right there, got the throw. We chose to aggressive because the guy was just completely stuck to him. Unfortunately, the pass was tipped for the hit. So a little sloppiness right there on our first drive with Vic, but we'll get it going. We got 50 seconds here. We need a score. We're with Vic. We're going to try go back to the doubles a little bit here. I'm going to take Hopkins out of the slot for Jordy. And we're going to see if we can scramble, make some plays, get in the open field. Some big-time playmakers, I think, could be coming up right now. That's the goal of this drive. You see the safeties coming up. Let's roll, baby. Take the sideline, get out, get 10, and just get the clock going. This is, you know, where you get a team that's got some juice. This is what you want to be doing. You can go a long way for your lineup. I'm going to try and run it to the left here one more time. If he clamps too far down, hopefully we'll be able to get it to Jordy. Simple setup here. I did not mean to hit RB right there, and we threw it by accident. So that was on me. My bad right there. Let's see what Dallas Clark can do for us. He still went through his progressions, and the receivers know that when the quarterback exits the pocket, they have defined routes to run now to get into his sight lines and try and help him out. End up throwing it short to the right. So crisp Jordy was on that cut right there, and then we get out of bounds. So that was a nice quick out route there from Vic. He had the safety blitz, a good throw, a good route. That's that 96 route running from Jordy. That's not subbed in, so that's how you know it's good, folks. He knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a second. I'm going to try and streak Johnson. Clark's going to be my playmaker here. So that was weird. I tried to get the ball out to RB. I stepped up in the pocket. I did see RB was open in the seam, but I couldn't get the ball out. I didn't know if that was a playmaker. Obviously, the ball came out real weird. Potential fumble situation. Let's go here. I'm going to slide left because that's where I want to roll. I want to look for Jordy Nelson. I'll just never understand that. That when you playmaker a halfback upfield, they instantly turn around. I'll never be able to fully grasp that because it's really not good for the way I play. 23 seconds, but I'm at the 36 yard line. I really like the way I have Jordy coming across the middle, playmaker. If I get protection, great job by Hopkins. That puts us at 12 seconds, so that was a good patient playmaker. We saw Hopkins get upfield. Nobody rushed me right there, so I just hung tough in the pocket. We're going to go to doubles. We're going to try and fit it to Jimmy Graham. I feel like that's our best chance. The only small issue, sometimes we get sacked out of this. Sometimes we do get sacked from this. But I feel like we'll be able to back up far enough now that we have Vic. They're going to say Jimmy. The haters are going to say Jimmy Graham's feet weren't in, but you know they were in. Can I get a challenge? Now we have 8 seconds. Dallas Clark, terrible at this type of route. Totally not his game. They'll look to throw again. And it's caught. Jerry Rice, who do you need when you need one? You call the GOAT. A good drive there with 50 seconds left at the end of the half. We saw a little bit of mobility helping, but overall, I mean, Vick made every throw, and that's kind of the key. Sometimes we got ourselves into trouble. Sometimes we get ourselves out of trouble. I mean, we bought a little time. We're going to keep exploring this one, so hopefully you guys will stay tuned to the channel. Going to have a lot of Vick gameplays coming up here, explore a lot of different playbooks, and see what we can get away with Vick. Because I don't want to just play regular style. That's not fun. I want to play like a clown and try and figure out how to get rewarded. So that's what I'll be doing here. Take back over on offense right here. This is Vick. We're going to come out under center in this one, and we're going to see if we can either potentially run the ball. You guys know the runs, right, from this set. It's the deuce close. It's in the Browns. It's in the Colts. It's in a lot of playbooks. It's the wham in the stretch, but I don't really want to run the wham in the stretch right now because that's just not fun. So what we're going to do is probably throw a pick with Michael Vick instead. We're going to run left, actually. We've got a wide-open touchdown. Rob Gronkowski, that's just too easy. Right there. Boom, Michael Vick. So that's where an example of he was way down in the box. The seam got open deep. We were patient enough to wait for it. We rolled. We had the drag. We had an angle route coming through. And then we had the deep ball. So that's, I'm going to credit that to Vick. A good throw. Good ability with the legs. Touchdown. So we didn't get a ton of looks at what that book actually brings to the table because we had broken a big touchdown pass. So we're back in the single back deuce close right here with Vick. We did sub in some better run blockers on the outside plus guys with playmaker for the drags. We're going to see if we can hit this off the right edge. I don't know if it's there. It is. Big truck. Give me a bigger truck right there, DJ. But yeah, you get the play tight end angle as your quick audible, so I think you want to come out in the misdirection play. I know that's a play that people really like to use. I have not had as much success with it. I haven't really put it in my arsenal, but people do like that play quite a bit. The wham doesn't fully appear there. Let's go to the tight end angle. We're going to roll left. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Dallas Clark right there bailed us out. He did drop deep. That was pretty nice. Vick threw a bullet of a pass. That was a really fast pass from Vick, which is nice. Now, we came out and bench because your quick audible stick, not bench. So if you want to, I mean, you could make bench, I guess. You can't really quite make bench. So bench, we're going to give it a shot. We're going to try an option route to the halfback. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's. We could not outrun the spy right there. That was one of the things we wanted to test. We didn't really get our timing right on the right trigger. We got to be better with our right trigger timing to hopefully give us more headway, more speed as we approach that guy. So we'll block the halfback here. This is more of a crosser situation. Wide open. So I'm not sure what this guy's doing besides not covering the deep middle seam, but seems to be working with Vick with the rollout with the backside. I like this little formation right here. This is the first time really running PA misdirection. It worked for us. It worked for us pretty good right there. He went to the bench. There's a little mini scheme right here. I mean, we've been running this since the start of the year. I've been running this before the game came out. But I went away from it once stretch slowed down. So I really ran this a lot if you go back and watch my videos from before the game started. But I did abandon it once the stretch started to slow down. But I might be getting back to it right now a little bit. Because if you can run for some of those yards with Vick, then you wouldn't need the stretch quite as much. And I've still seen other people stick with the stretch. So single back, deuce close. DRC finally gets the pick right there. We finally made a good user play. I'm gonna stick in the deuce. I'm gonna stick in the deuce close. See what he's gonna bring to the table here. We're on the left hash, which isn't great. We'd rather be on the right hash, but we got obviously flip this formation super quick. Get Fitzgerald then on that drag. And just simply hit it right there. Break a tackle. Break another tackle. Break two tackles. Hurdle. Gallop. do whatever, get down the sideline. So that's what's nice about that, is you can easily work the quick flip for more. I don't know how I feel about the drag wheel, but we could try it. I'm gonna go to bench for now. You have tight end angle, you have the drag wheel, you have stick. So we're in bench. I can motion Jordy out. I could use an option route out of the backfield. Nothing here. So what that's Gunslinger just getting the ball out. What I really need to do is not slow down when I get to the corner. That's been my biggest tendency, that I'm going to throw a Z spot for the bread. But I've been making a tendency mistake where I want a playmaker, but Vic's getting out there so quickly that the playmaker's not ready, so I stop because I want to go, but then I can't get back up to speed really quick. So once I have the momentum with Vick, I just got to take off. I just got to take off and get as many as I can, and eventually I'll get a playmaker. But he's guarding it pretty well. This guy's in quarter street deep. I don't expect pressure, but I'll pick it up anyways. Oh, we got him. That's a tough throw from Vick right there. Down to the two. Down to the two. Do we go back to the Wildcat? We started this game in the Wildcat. We got our first touchdown on it today. I think this guy could run commit right here for the blast, because we ran the blast the first time. So I am going to call the jet sweep right here for the marbles. So for the marbles, for a two-score lead in the fourth quarter, I'm going to call jet sweep and hope this guy run commits. Pretty much worked to my plan. I don't think he actually ran commit, but he did kind of pack down everybody in the middle right there, and it worked for us for the easy score. So that's that little Wildcat red zone scheme that you get. I mean, you could get that without Vic. We've shown you that, but I think it does make it a little bit more deadly, just because it's a nuisance. It's a nuisance for them to have to slow down and think about every time you get to the red zone. So make sure to add that to your game. I think we can secure the quit right here in our first playoff game with a stop on fourth down. Let's get it. Don't falcon this, Farls. We got this. Come on. One stop. Everything rides on. Got him. Give me the quit. All right. Back on offense it is. We're going to go empty tray here. I'm going to go goes wide shake. I'm going to run streaks like a 10-year-old child, and I'm gonna run with the quarterback like it's man-to-man. Don't turn your back on Michael Vick. That's what they say. Let's get it right here. We're scrambling big time. No, we're not. Yes, we are. No, we're not. So he's pretty fast. We somehow screwed it up. We did not do a good job tapping the right trigger. That gives you the fastest control. We head into the fourth quarter. Once we got through the line of scrimmage, he accelerates really, really quickly. So I like that, but we got to get ahead of steam prior to the line if we're going to be successful with Gunslinger Vick as our quarterback. That's going to be the name of the game for us. Can we get that head of steam? And as we roll out, can we find some playmaker guys? You know? That was not what we were looking for. Probably had a touchdown. We're going to go back to the halfback wide trips weak. We're going to run four verts.
And the back goes into motion. Time running out here on the play clock.
That's first down. Ball came out on time. That's a gunslinger. Quick release. That's not very high throw power. A lot of good factors went into that one. I know we showed you a couple shovel options on some other drives here on this channel, but we'll try and run one more right here, as it looks like we do have the edge. Although he covered. That's Vic. So that's Vic all the way. He covered the halfback, which they usually don't do. That guy did that time, and Vic was still fast enough to get there. Obviously, he's not running at full speed because it's shovel option, but he still had enough juice to get to the corner, forced a quit on our opponent, and get us this W here in our first Vick gameplay. We hang 42 points after not even getting the ball until the second quarter. So I'm really impressed with what this Vick is able to do. He's a Ferrari. I don't know how to drive him yet. I banged into a wall one time. Little scuff here, scuff there. But I'm still thinking that this Colts-Browns playbook gives you enough. Gives you enough different stuff and enough like balance to kind of just make him a weapon of your choice. I need to utilize playmakers better. I need to get a better head of steam and not force it, but I was trying to force it for you guys at home. So until next time, guys, that's a little Michael Vick gameplay. Lock up, follow the channel. We're going to have more schemes, more power. That's the Home Depot motto. Doesn't even make sense. Catch you guys soon.